Hello and welcome back to the finals of the World Championship in Through the Ages. You had to wait quite a while, but now I've finally found some time again so that we can take a look at the next game. As you can see at the moment, I have quite a nice position in the standings with 9 games finished and 34 points, but Himmelstosh, who is in the second place, has 2 less games finished, so I definitely still should try to score as many points as possible, and the next chance to do so, I will have in the next 2-player game that we are taking a look at now, and that will be a 2-player game against Cengizip. Yeah, now without further ado, we are going right into the game. I'm in the first position in this game, and first of all we can take a look at the leaders and wonders. And we can see that there is quite some culture synergy in the game, especially in H3. There is Chaplin, Fleming, Marlene Dietrich, also Hollywood and the internet, only there's no Gandhi to potentially hide behind. There is also Marie Curie and Einstein. H2, we have also Bach, not a lot of other culture leaders, but in total definitely a nice amount of culture synergy. We have also Maria Theresa and the Ocean Liner Service is a potentially strong combination. There is James Watt, we have James Cook, but no Suez Canal. The Harvard College is there, so a strong wonder. We have one military action leader with Catherine. In H1 there are 2 military action leaders with Jan Žižka and Chin of Arc. There's also Leonardo da Vinci as for some lab and printing press synergy. Barbarossa and Eleanor are there, also Genghis Khan. We have also the both of the strength wonders, Great Wall and Himeji Castle. St. Peter's Basilica is there for some nice happy faces and also the Machu Picchu. And now, I at the end made the decision to take Boudica here at my first turn. I could also, I think I like Boudica more than Hippocrates, so I go for her, but I could of course also think about not committing to a leader yet, and then maybe Cengizip has to take Hammurabi now, but no, he might potentially pick him anyway. I mean, if he has to pick him, maybe I have a chance to get a Stonehenge then, but I would not have Boudica available then. I would have to take one of those yellow cards, which would maybe not that be ideal, and also there is the Acropolis in the deck, and with that amount of culture synergy, that could be a strong wonder to get, and then maybe I don't want to commit to the Stonehenge already, and so at the end I just go for Boudica here. I think she's quite a strong leader, and that will of course mean that Cengizip will be able to go for Hammurabi, but that is how it is. And interestingly, Cengizip is committing to the Stonehenge here, meaning that he will not have the chance to go for the Acropolis if that wonder should be revealed, so an interesting decision. It of course means that he will get Hammurabi at the next turn, and also of course it is not certain that the Acropolis will be revealed. It's only a bit more of a 50% chance. So if this Acropolis is not revealed, then he has a fine wonder for himself, while I maybe don't have the chance to go for a nice wonder cheaply at my next turn. And as you can see, there are 2 wonders revealed, but no Acropolis, so Cengizip taking the Stonehenge did work out quite nicely for him. And I go now for Boudica. I will build my first mine, increase my population, and then I take the stockpile, just because I know for certain that I can use it, while with the rich land I don't really know if I maybe get iron or irrigation early, or if I maybe have the free population to build a 4th mine or 3rd farm or something like this. So I just go for the stockpile, a pretty standard turn, I would say. The next turn I can then maybe think about if I want to take the Colossus potentially. Rome Roads for Thieves, 2 civil actions could maybe be a bit too expensive. As you can see, there are some interesting cards coming down the road. There's a copy of Code of Laws, copy of Iron, also the printing press, even though there's no Shakespeare or Goldie in the game, so maybe not the biggest printing press synergy, but definitely some interesting cards coming down the row. Cengizip could potentially grab one of those for 3 civil actions if he wants to, but he instead just makes the decision to build a mine, increase his population, and he takes the urban growth. And with the urban growth, potentially he could. If I should, for example, go for Code of Laws and Iron, which might happen at my next turn, then Cengizip now can build one stage of the Stonehenge. That gives him enough science to go for the printing press, and thanks to the urban growth, he would still have enough resources to build one immediately. And then at my turn, as said, I will indeed just grab the Iron and the Code of Laws. I took one science from Boudica. And now, I think both of those wonders would be very strong for Cengizip, together with the Stonehenge. Getting the Code of Laws would be very nice, but also getting a very early iron would be quite strong for him. That leaves him now with the printing press, but as said, there is at least not that big of a printing press synergy. I mean, in H3 it could definitely be nice to have, with Hollywood, internet and Fleming being there, but I was hoping that it's maybe not too strong to let the printing press fall down for one civil action to a Chengisip, and I thought that those two cards are just more important. And thanks to the science from Boudica, if I will be able to take her science again at the next turn, I can even go for Iron immediately the next turn. With that, I think it's also not that bad to miss out on an HA Wonder, because I have something nice to invest my resource into, and who knows, maybe I can even go for the Mitchie Castle at the next turn. So I was quite happy that I have the chance to get this early Iron, and thanks to the science from Boudica, I also have the chance to get this going quite quickly. Then I draw two cards, the Heavy Cavalry Tactic and also I think the Uncertain Borders. Cengizip will take Jan Šiška for two civil actions, has now his H1 leader available, builds a second lab so he won't go for the printing press, and increases his population, builds one step of the Stonehenge. Now it is my turn, I again take the Science from Boudica, and then I just start with building two iron, with going for two iron upgrades. I could of course also build a second lab, but there's the second copy of Printing Press coming down the row, and also Leonardo, so that could potentially be an interesting combination, and with that I didn't want to commit to my second lab yet, and also I think just getting the resource production going is quite strong. Now I have one civil action left, I could potentially just increase my population, I could even think about grabbing a copy of Printing Press already this turn, but at the end I made a decision to indeed go for the Mitchie Castle, because I get my iron production going here very very quickly, so hopefully I will have enough resources to finish the Mitchie Castle without neglecting other areas of my civilization, especially without being able to improve my economy. And so I go for the Mitchie Castle here, and also, you know Cengizip, he is a bit of a military-heavy, playstyle, and that was actually a bit of a part of my decision-making here. I thought having the Mitchie Castle against him might not be bad to have, especially because he has already taken Jan Šiška. At the moment he's still at Hammurabi, but at some point he will get Jan Šiška, and then it could be quite nice to have the Mitchie Castle, also in case I go for a culture leader, maybe Bach in H2, it could be nice to have the Mitchie Castle, and with that have quite a bit of protection against potential military solutions from Cengizip. So I thought the Mitchie Castle is a nice wonder to get here. Keep the knowledge of the ancients and the heavy cavalry tactic, draw the strategic territory in the Reign of Terror. Cengizip will still go for the masonry, even though he already built a stage at a turn before, but it will still, I think, be a fine technology for him. He then takes the urban growth, the swordsman, and also builds one stage of the Stonehenge, and at the next turn he can finish the Stonehenge if he wants to, with only spending one civil action. Again, I took the science from Boudica, I will go for one last upgrade to my iron mines, I will increase my population to get out of corruption, and then I really wanted to go for Leonardo here, because I think he can give my economy quite a nice boost. I delayed my second lab a bit, which was not too bad, because I took the science from Boudica every turn, but still getting now a big science boost could be quite nice. First I thought it might be better to go for the Alchemy at the next turn, because the Printing Press is of course quite nice, but I thought with not the biggest Printing Press synergy being in there, it could also be quite strong to just go for the Alchemy, and with that for a bit more economical strength. But there's a bit of a problem. First of all, Cengizip could potentially deny the Alchemy, but that was not my main concern, because there's also an Iron, he maybe wants to start upgrading, so I thought that he has some strong alternatives in grabbing the Alchemy for two, with there even being a second copy left that I then can go for at some point. Could be quite bad, and so I was hoping that the Alchemy will be available, but what I was afraid of is that Cengizip, maybe just with electing Jan Šiška or with some other stuff, might be able to get a bit stronger relatively cheaply, and then I can't take the science from Boudica at the next turn, which then would mean I can't go for the Alchemy at the next turn, and that would then just delay the science boost by quite a bit. And so because of that threat, I didn't like that too much, and having the printing press is also still quite nice, gives me even more culture production with the Mitchie Castle. Hopefully I can afford putting one or two workers into printing presses, and so I at the end just went for the printing press, because now I can guaranteed go for the printing press at the next turn, I have enough science, and then at the next turn Leonardo will be able to give me a nice boost to my science production. I then draw two cards, the Pestilence and a defense card, Shengisip will seed, so the first event is pushed and the development of planning is revealed. The options for that are development of politics, civil life and raid routes, so the decision will very likely be between civil life and raid routes. Shengisip goes for the iron, will start some production, goes for one upgrade, increases population to get out of corruption and then takes the urban growth. And with that can maybe start going for some cheap buildings at some point, maybe even also do some upgrades to the alchemy. I think, again, it took the science from Boudica. I will switch to Leonardo this turn. I could potentially still think about going for the alchemy, but now that I already have spent a civil action to take the printing press, I just thought that might be the better thing to do. I used the development of civil life from the development of planning to increase my population, and now I have two population available that are free, meaning I can go for two printing presses immediately, going up to four science production, and then I even have even one civil action left that I can use to take this breakthrough. At the next turn, I also have just enough science to finish resources to finish the Magic Castle if I want to, so that could also be quite nice. And generally, I was relatively happy about my position, being able to go for all of those iron upgrades that quickly, and now having a nice science boost. And as soon as I've finished the Magic Castle, I will also be able to have quite a decent amount of culture production already. I was eyeing this St. Peter's Basilica. I thought I could maybe just finish the Magi Castle and take the St. Peter's Basilica, but I also thought that maybe it could be taken away by Chengisip because it synergizes nicely with the happy face from the Stonehenge and sets himself maybe up quite nicely for a potential Bach or just to get a nice source for the happy faces. Chengisip will go for one more upgrade, goes for Janšiška now, takes the alchemy, and then will take the knights and goes for one more iron upgrade, so doesn't go for the alchemy upgrades yet, but he will get some science from the Stonehenge, and then he can go for those alchemy upgrades quite cheaply with going for the urban growth. But as you can see, he didn't go for the St. Peter's Basilica, instead wanted to complete his iron upgrades, which also makes sense, but it also means that the St. Peter's Basilica will be available for me as an option. And this turn I will finish the Magic Castle, that's just a very easy way for me to get out of corruption. And then, as you can see, I indeed went for the St. Peter's Basilica. That comes a bit of a cost, because, for example, I could have taken another copy of Breakthrough, that could be quite nice. Maybe now the stockpile will be discarded, so there is a bit of a cost involved, but I just thought St. Peter's Basilica is quite a strong wonder to have. Now that I have Himeji Castle and those printing presses, with getting the St. Peter's Basilica on top, I will have 6 culture production, and that already puts quite a bit of pressure maybe on Chengisip. And with the Magic Castle, I am maybe nicely prepared for military push, but now with having already 4 culture production at some point from the Wonders together with those printing presses, I also put quite a bit of pressure on him with the culture production, and I also have a decent economy. So I thought the St. Peter's Basilica is just quite nice in case I get Bach. That works very nicely together with the theaters. So, it also means that I maybe can't as easily take something like the Oceanliner Service or the Harvard College, but I just thought the St. Peter's Basilica gives me something nice here, and with that I was willing to take it. Also, in case Chengisip goes for a bit of military, he has Janšiška after all, has maybe a bunch of free population as soon as he finishes the Stonehenge, and I thought, if in case Chengisip goes for military push, the St. Peter's Basilica might actually also help me with that. With getting one additional happy face, I can put an additional worker into the military, and that could also be quite important. And so at the end I went for the St. Peter's Basilica and thought that wonder might be quite nice for me to have. I draw another defense card that could be nice, also the developed territory, Chengisip seeds, and the development of settlement is revealed. He will finish the Stonehenge. Goes for two very cheap upgrades to alchemies. Actually, those upgrades don't cost him any resources. And then he reveals the medieval army tactic, takes the drama, so he now has technology in hand with which he maybe can go for Bach potentially at some point. And interestingly, he reveals the medieval army tactic. That means that at the next turn, in case he goes for knights, he can potentially build 3 knights and have the tactic 3 times then, putting him at 13 strength. So that's definitely something to be a bit concerned about. Of course, we shouldn't forget that the age will end, so one of those workers will be unhappy, but there are some developments that would allow him to get an additional population, and then he would be able to go for just 3 knights. He has enough resource with enough military actions as well, so that's something to be a bit concerned about, so I should try to prepare myself to have an answer in case Chengisip indeed goes for that strength push. And because of that potential threat, I made a decision to go for the monarchy here. First I thought I maybe just want to develop the code of laws to get the additional civil action. But if I don't take the monarchy here and if I stay on two military actions, I thought things could definitely get a bit dangerous, and I thought a third military action from the monarchy could just make me quite a bit safer in case the game stays peacefully. And having the monarchy also allows me to put an additional work into the printing press, so it could also help with that. I still thought about only taking the monarchy in hand and then developing the code of laws now, leaving myself open for an H2 government form. That could also be nice, because if one is available, then I, with not having committed to the monarchy yet, could maybe take it, deny it from Cengizip, but still being able to use it for myself. But I thought if Cengizip goes for that strength push, it could be nice to have the monarchy already developed and then still have enough science to go for knights. And if I go for the code of laws now, I can't go for monarchy and for knights at the next turn, and the stuff could potentially get a bit dangerous. Of course, I might be able, also with going for code of laws and knights, to defend myself with sacrificing the Themichi castle, but that's also a bit of a cost to sacrifice, so I have to be careful about that. And with that, I, to play it a bit safer, went for the monarchy to get my third military action and to be able to, no, maybe have more cards in hand to defend myself. Then I increase my population, I play the stockpile, I increase my population again, that gets me out of corruption. Also, it means that I'm very nicely at zero food. Hopefully being making it that I don't have any difficulties to get out of corruption. Of course, there might still be some food revealed from the development, so that, of course, can be the case. So I play my turn like this. I could have also thought about taking one of those yellow cards, not because those are that great for me. I mean, Cultural Heritage is definitely a fine card, but I also have some fine science production. But with taking one of those cards, I would make it for certain that the knights will be available for one civil action for me. Now Cengizip could let the knights stay on two civil actions. At least it would mean that he doesn't take the Engineering Genius, which maybe could potentially be a nice card for him. Maybe also not that strong with having the Masonry. So, I thought about taking one of those cards, but it just didn't play out that nicely, and at the end I just went for this turn to get out of corruption, to make use out of the stockpile that I have in hand, and to now be very nicely at zero food. And at the next turn, if the knight should be available for one civil action, I could potentially finish the St. Peter's Basilica and I would still have enough resources to go for two knights. However, if the knights stay on two civil actions, then I can't go for knights and finish the St. Peter's Basilica, so that could be a bit of a problem, but I was hoping that I would still find some solutions to prepare myself nicely, especially because if there's no development revealed that gives additional food to Cengizip, he doesn't have enough workers to build three knights immediately, so I can also have some hope that Cengizip maybe goes for a strength push, but maybe is able to go for that much of strength. I will also reveal the heavy cavalry tactic to spend a military action now in H1, and then I can maybe potentially just go for a bunch of knights at some point to defend myself and to get more strength going. Now it's Cengizip's turn. He will see it. The development of crafts is revealed, so no additional food for him. He will go for the knights, and also, as you can see, there is a very early Bach available. And der Bach is basically the only strong culture leader in H2, so he could be quite an important card, and after seeing him revealed, I was very curious if Cengizip will be willing to take him. And the longer I thought about it, the more I was convinced that Cengizip has to go for him here. He has the drama in hand, and leaving him to me with having St. Peter's Basilica and Themichi Castle could be quite dangerous, but let's see what Cengizip will be doing. He goes for knight, he goes for another knight, going up to 9 strength. Sadly for him, because of the development of crafts, that is not enough to get out of corruption, and then as you can see, he is indeed going for Bach, and together with the dramas has now also a relatively cheap way to get more cultural production going, but at the moment he has only one free population. Maybe he can get another one with the development, but that could maybe be a bit of an issue. He also doesn't have enough science to go for a government form at the next turn if one should be available, so he has maybe some issues, but with Bach and drama, of course, he has a very cheap way to just get a lot of cultural production going. With only going for two knights, Cengizip is at 9 strength now, but thanks to having drawn those defense cards, I don't necessarily have to increase my strength, because I have 3 in hand and I can defend myself even without sacrificing. And so instead of maybe going for the knights and developing them, I instead developed a code of laws, because that allows me to finish the St. Peter's Basilica, getting me out of corruption, and then I might still made the decision to go for knights, because Cengizip, there could still be a development left, he could still go for an additional knight, and then if I don't take the knights, it could just be dangerous, I could have some problems to defend myself, even if the cavalrymen are revealed. I only have 5 science, so in case Cengizip goes for the strength push, I could have some problems, and because of that I went for the knights here for 2 civil actions. There are a lot of food technologies coming down the road, 2 copies of irrigations and a selective breeding, so Cengizip potentially could deny all of those from me, but it would be quite costly. He has not a lot of civil action, not a lot of hand space, so it would be very costly for him, and there's also still the ocean liner service, so I thought it's not that important to take a copy of irrigation here, and maybe I can even have some hopes to get the selective breeding at some the next turn. And if not, then hopefully I will be able to get this copy of irrigation. I keep all of the defense cards in case Cengizip goes for more strength. I could potentially even also maybe in preparation for potential strength events, I could build a religion at the next turn, develop the knights, and then I would have 3 free population in order to go for a heavy cavalry tactic, complete 1 tactic. However, I draw the defensive army now, and with that, it's of course a bit awkward investing too heavily into knights, so that will be an interesting question for me the next turn, if I even want to go for those knights, or if I can maybe somehow manage it to instead rather set myself up for a potential defensive army. Cengizip seeds, and the development of warfare is revealed, so no additional population. Instead of the development of warfare, Cengizip isn't really able to take this one, and he again takes the cards from the 3 civil action area. There's again a very strong card available, this time it's the ocean liner service. It is somewhat expensive for him, but I think it might definitely be the correct choice, because while it is expensive for him to take, at least he has the masonry, so it's not that expensive for him to finish. And it's just a very strong wonder, if he doesn't take it, then I will be able to take it, and it would be quite a nice wonder for me. And with having Bach and Dramas, getting a lot of population is just very strong for him, and also the big advantage for him is that he can finish the ocean liner service and fix his population without spending any science, meaning that at the next turn he can go for government form, and also has another way to nicely fix his population. So yeah, I think going for this ocean liner service definitely makes a lot of sense. At least that leaves some interesting cards available for me on the row. I take the selective breeding. I definitely also want to have to wait for myself to get more population. Also, as you can see, I was willing to take the development of warfare, and with that, it's relatively clear that my plan is now not to go for a heavy cavalry tactic any longer. There is a copy of Rifleman available, also a copy of Cannons. I won't take both, but I will take the copy of Rifleman, and then I was hoping that I will get the second copy of Cannons, that either Cengizip will take this copy and then I will get the next one, or if not, maybe I still have a chance to get a copy of Cannons, and then I was rather preparing myself to go into the defensive army at some point, and with that I was willing to take the development of warfare. I take the selective breeding. I could just start upgrading to the selective breeding, but there are just some interesting cards that I really want to take. First of all, there's a very cheap breakthrough available, there are the riflemen available, and with that, and also with me committing the science into the selective breeding this turn, with that I would not be able to go for riflemen at the next turn, and Cengizip could finish the ocean liner service and build another knight. And he could also even go for the strategy, so I have to be a bit careful here, and so I was didn't want to be in a position where I don't have enough science to go for Rifleman at the next turn. I could of course also take the strategy away, but taking selective breeding, a Rifleman and a strategy would be quite expensive. I would miss out on those breakthroughs, and so at the end I was willing to sadly let the strategy fall down to 1 civil action for Cengizip. At least Cengizip doesn't have that many civil actions, so it's not that easy for him to take Cannons, breakthrough, strategy. He can maybe only easily take 1 or maybe 2 out of those interesting cards. So with that I was willing to give him the chance to take the strategy, probably he will take it, but it just was a bit too expensive for me to go for it this turn. And then after having taken all of those cards, I also still want to get out of corruption, and I will do that with building a religion that fixes my happy faces. I thought there's at least a chance that maybe a rebellion could be in there. And then also I just went for another printing press that gets me out of corruption and increases my science production even more. I have already two workers and warriors, and with being able to put one more into potentially cannons, I would be able to fulfill one tactic, and so I was hoping that it's not too greedy, it will give me an economical benefit and also increase my culture production even more, so hopefully I will be able to get a bit of a lead before Genghis will be able to build up some culture production with Bach. And no, and I just get a bit more science, and at the next turn, thanks to the breakthrough, I have enough science to go for both selective breeding and rifleman if I want to. Also, I revealed a defensive army already this turn because I need to, if I want to keep it in hand, I need to keep two H1 defense cards in hand to be able to defend myself without needing to sacrifice a warrior. But if I don't review, if I keep it in hand, meaning that means I have to discard both of those events. And I thought with having the defensive army tactic, maybe if I fulfill one, I could have a chance to win those refugees. And so I wanted to keep those refugees in hand, but I could maybe also just keep the defensive army in hand. But the refugees is a potentially strong card, so at the end I made the decision to keep it in hand. But of course that gives Genghis some information now. Maybe he could try to deny the cannons at some point, potentially. And so I'm not sure if that is the correct move here. But of course the refugees might have some potential at some point. I draw two defense cards that of course could be very nice to have. And Genghis will go for an aggression against me, the kidnap. With that he could take the rifleman away from me, for example, so I definitely want to defend this. Question is, do I want to spend an H1 and an H2 defense card, or do I now want to discard the refugees? And as you see, I made the decision to discard the refugees. I mean, I just kept it in hand because it could potentially be strong, but at the end I was not willing to sacrifice an H2 defense card in order to keep the refugees here. Genghis goes for the Republic, that is available for him, and he can take it and the strategy and finish the ocean liner service, so that is strong for him. And but that means that this copy of cannon will be discarded, and this copy of cannon will be available for me, so it is a bit of a tough decision for him. He knows that I have the defensive army, but he could go for Republic and just grab the cannons, but with that he would miss out on the strategy, then he would have some issues with the military actions, and he would also delay the ocean liner service even more. Even though delaying the ocean liner service is maybe not even that big of a deal, because interestingly, when we take a look at the log, after the ocean liner service wonder is completed, Genghis made a decision to actually not use it. So that is a very interesting decision and could definitely give us some hints about potential events. Because if he would have now used the ocean liner service, he would have had an unhappy worker, meaning that there might be a rebellion in there. But it might not only be the rebellion that causes this, because now he produced already some additional food, but before that he was stuck at 3 food if he uses the ocean liner service. Then he would be stuck on 3 food for a while, but with saving up the food, he will now be able to increase his population one time normally, with that basically getting the population back that he lost to the ocean liner service. And also he won't be stuck on having that much food lying around, which will maybe make it easier for him to get out of corruption. So an interesting decision. I think only the rebellion might not be reason enough, because it's just not certain at all if it will be revealed. So I think, and he also has now a nice amount of civil actions, so I think only the rebellion is not reason enough, but with him being stuck on 3 food and with him now being able to spend his food to get an additional population out, that combined with maybe a potentially rebellion is maybe reason enough for him to not use the ocean liner service this turn. Now it is my turn, I will go for the cannons, and as you can see, I actually make the decision to develop the cannons immediately, because with building one, I'm at 10 strength. Genghis had Jan Šuška for a while, he seeded all of those events in there, meaning there could definitely be some strength events, and with that I thought it could be nice to maybe get a bit stronger, especially because it's not that expensive for me, I just need to build this one cannon. I have the 3 population for it, and even after building this cannon, I still have enough resource to go for 2 upgrades to the selective breeding, making it that I can increase my population at the next turn. So I just thought that is a very strong turn. I miss out on those yellow cards, but if I take those, it also means that Newton will be discarded, and I thought Newton could potentially be a leader that might potentially be strong for me. Otherwise, there might be Maria Theresa and Catherine, who also could both be fine, but Newton will be available for certain for me at the next turn for one civil action. And so I thought Newton might be nice to have, and also I have a decent amount of resource, so missing out on those 2 yellow cards is maybe not too bad. Then I draw the politics of strength in the vast territory. Jankisip increases population normally one time, and now one time with the ocean liner service builds an additional knight going up to 13 strength, but he will switch to Bach. That of course means that he loses some strength now, and then he goes for two dramas. That's just enough resource for that, with that also again making sure that he has enough happy faces to not, which again could be another hint that there is a rebellion coming. And while he went weaker for a while, he now copies the heavy cavalry tactic to again be stronger, sacrifices two draws for that, which could be a hint that there are indeed some strength events in there. And then he just takes some yellow cards. Now it is my turn, I go for Newton here, and also I think a very important pick here is the Journalism. First of all, it works nicely together with Newton, making it that they can maybe get a big bit of a bigger boost out of him. But I think it's also important to go for the Journalism as a denial, because Jankisip now can just go for one more drama, then he has reached his urban building limit, he has done a decent amount of cultural production, but then he can maybe upgrade to opera, but that's not really an efficient way to, for him to get more cultural production going, and now with the Journalism gone, he just can't really do any a lot more easily. While I have the Journalism, I can be maybe grab one of those operas at the next one. So even though I don't have a culture lead available, I was hoping, especially with having those two culture producing wonders available and all of those printing presses, that I might be able to keep up with culture production. Because at the moment I have only three military actions, I have maybe a nice way to get more strength with having Rifleman and the defensive army tactic. But I don't have any wars in hand, I have only three military actions, I don't know if I will get the military theory, so I just thought it's maybe not the right way to go for a military push here, or at least not for a push with expecting that that will be enough to maybe compete against Bach. And so instead I was rather looking on how I maybe can compete in a potential culture race, and I think for that it's just very important to take the Journalism away here. And then one idea that I had was to go for the Journalism immediately, probably with electing Newton and then getting an even bigger science boost. That could mean that I have done enough science to even go for the opera at the next turn. That could be nice, giving me a science boost already this turn and also improving my cultural production even more. But with Jankisip being willing to copy the tactic, sacrifice some draws in order to get stronger, I thought there might be some strength events. And because of that, I made a decision to not go for the Journalism. I will still go for Newton, because I thought the civil action is worth more now than the one resource from Leonardo. And then I will go for the Rifleman. I will go for two upgrades, going up to 17 strength. And with having that much strength, even if Jankisip goes for the strategy and maybe one more knight, he can't overtake me. Meaning that at the next turn, he can maybe start pushing some events, maybe even the politics of strength. With having this tactic, maybe I have chances to be able to win that at some point, and then I can start pushing some events and maybe even win some strength events potentially. I still have enough science to go for Journalism at the next turn, that could be quite important. I don't have enough science to go for the opera, meaning I maybe can't fix my happy faces at the next turn, meaning I might potentially be in danger of a rebellion, but I was hoping that the next turn will still be H2, and then there's maybe only a very short amount of time where I'm without happy faces, and then hopefully in two turns I can go for opera. So my plan was to go for Journalism at the next turn and in two turns for opera. And while I miss out on some culture production with delaying the Journalism, and of course also some science production, but I think the culture production is not that bad, because now at least I'm stronger and I can get the culture back from seeding. And as said, maybe I can also hope to win some strength events. So I thought it is nice to go for those Rifemen, also missing out on H2 draws instead of at some point missing out on H3 draws. And then with my last civil actions, I take the reserves and I just increase my population. I draw the National Pride, Jankisip seeds, so he seeds now, even though being the weakest, which could mean that there are no strength events coming, but he also doesn't really have a way to get stronger, so he might just push anyway, and the first event revealed is the cultural influence, giving us a relatively equal amount of culture. And then Jankisip will use the ocean liner service, goes for a third drama, but with that he basically has reached his maximum, at least for now, on how much culture he can produce. Of course he can build religions maybe, or some other stuff, but he can't easily go for even a lot more culture reduction. And then he also just takes two yellow cards, goes for the strategy, but he stays weaker, meaning at my turn I can may push if I want to. Also the age doesn't end, so at this point I'm not in danger of a potential rebellion. I have to make a decision between politics of strength or national pride. And Cengizil, with having Bachen, with being a 12 culture reduction, I thought he might overtake me. The good thing is I'm in first position, so that of course helps with the national pride, but at the end I rather went for the politics of strength with having the defensive army tactic with Cengizil. Not having maybe the easiest way to get a lot of strength, depending on what tactic he has, but the swordsman will be discarded. And he has only the knights available, he also missed out on the cannons. I was hoping that I have chances to win the politics of strength, also I have knowledge about it and maybe can prepare for it, if in case Cengizil tries to go for more strength. So I see the politics of strength, and there is indeed a strength event in there, the call to arms, and that could actually be quite annoying for Cengizil, because now with having lost two civil actions, he can't go for Harvard College and finish at the next turn, which otherwise could be a strong move to really boost his science production. But now he can only take it and has one civil action left, so that could definitely be an annoying event revealed for him, and with that maybe my strength push has already paid off. I then this turn go for the journalism, getting a science boost and also a little bit of a culture boost. I go for one upgrade, I take the opera, I take the wave of nationalism. I thought about also taking the architecture, but Cengizil has the masonry, so I thought I might also still have a chance to take the architecture the next turn. And also I maybe can't, maybe it's not that easily for me to implement the architecture, because of the next turn I maybe also want already, want to go for the opera, to be prepared for a rebellion and to just also keep up with the culture production. And then in the turn after that I could maybe develop the architecture, save potentially some resources, but with investing my science into the architecture maybe it's also a bit more difficult for me to go for an H3 government form at some point, which could potentially be nice to do. So I thought, first of all, I can still go for that the next turn, and also maybe it's not really certain if I actually want to have this card. I wanted to have the wave of nationalism, I thought it could be interesting for me, especially with having seeded a politics of strength, so that I'm just hopefully nicely prepared for a strength race in case that should happen. And then with my remaining civil actions, I first of all went for another upgrade, going for even more science. That means that if I want to build opera the next turn, I need to play the reserves, so maybe that gives me a little bit less flexible. But no, I also just didn't want to increase my population to spend a civil action, because there might be a rebellion in there, and so it just was a nice way for me to spend my civil action, and I thought I can maybe also just do it that I play the reserves at the next turn. I also thought about playing the reserves already this turn, but at the end I thought it might be nice to have the cavalryman, because that could maybe open up some nice possibilities for me to go for an H3 government form. I could also deny this copy of cavalryman from Cengizil. This could especially be nice in case he has hussars. But then that means that architecture would be discarded, and while it is maybe a bit difficult to implement, I also thought it could definitely still generate a bit of value for me, so I didn't want to remove this option from me. I draw some cards, the terrorism, so I have no national pride and terrorism in hand, and depending on what I think, how the culture race is going, I can maybe seed the one or the other event. Cengizil will seed. And sadly, there is indeed now the rebellion revealed, so after Cengizil lost two civil actions due to call to arms, now I'm the one who will lose two civil actions. Cengizil, I was interested to see what he will do now, because he can't finish the Harvard College, and maybe he will just be forced to take some cards. There's also an early Fleming on the row, which could be very interesting. Could be a potentially strong culture leader for me, but also maybe at some point when Cengizil will get one of the two copies of Multimedia, could be a strong wonder for him, with going for Hollywood and Internet potentially. First of all, Cengizil will go for a fourth mine, interestingly, with using the rich land. He will then disband a unit of warrior, also building an additional farm that gets him out of corruption and makes it that he doesn't have any minus food production any longer. And then he takes the engineering genius and the efficient upgrade, and maybe he can still potentially think about going for the Harvard College the next turn, and then even with having the engineering genius. But he doesn't take Fleming, and with that leaves that option available for me. I will seed the national pride now, because I will go for Fleming this turn. I thought I might have some chances to win that one, especially because I'm in first position, and when Cengizil seeds, I always have already an additional production phase behind me. And also, I just thought I have the better chances. It's not completely secure, but I thought it is a risk worth taking, especially because I wanted to move the deck forward, because at the moment I'm still stronger. And with that, it would also be nice to see the politics of strength revealed as quickly as possible. And yeah, then I will go for Fleming this turn. I think he is just a must grab, basically, because he just improves my culture production immediately. Like this, I have a culture leader that I can use to keep up with Bach, or maybe even produce more, because I have those journalisms and the opera, while Cengizip only has those dramas at the moment. And if I don't take him, then Cengizip will be able to take him, can maybe go for multimedia at some point, can potentially go for very big internet or Hollywood, which he might still be able to do, because there are also still Marlene Dietrich and Chaplin there, but still, I thought Fleming could also potentially be strong for him. If I don't take him, I was very convinced that he will be taken away, so I have to go for him now, and I also wanted to set himself up. I wanted to set him up immediately. I built one opera, developing the opera with Newton, and then I go for Fleming, going up to 17 culture production, and to get out of corruption, I will increase my population. And then I will draw some cards, another defense card that could potentially be nice in case there's a colony coming, and also two impacts, both of which are not that great, but at least the impact of industry might at least be seedable. Not really that great, because Cengizip has now four mines, but you know, maybe at least a fine impact. But I will even get more cards now, because the politics of strength is revealed, meaning that I will draw now five additional cards. Cengizip will miss out on one draw step, so that is definitely quite a big swing, and quite a strong card to see revealed now, just after H3 has started. And as you can see, I have some interesting cards in hand now. The impact of culture could have some potential with me having Fleming now. I have also a modern army tactic that I can use with going for Cavalryman. Impact of competition could maybe be playable. Wonders is not that great, so no. But the impact of culture has some potential, and having the modern army tactic is also quite nice. Cengizip goes for the civil service, can develop it immediately with playing the revolutionary idea, and thanks to the additional civil actions that he gets immediately, he still has enough civil actions to just take and finish the Harvard College. Interestingly, he doesn't use the engineering genius, but that would mean that he has corruption, and with that, he is not willing to use it, and then he also can use the ocean liner service. And now, after his turn has finished, we can maybe take a look at the overview, because I think it's actually a relatively close position here. I have a bit of a culture lead, but only a very tiny bit of a culture lead. But at least I also have a bit more culture reduction, and maybe the National Pride can potentially enhance my culture lead even more. But I was a little bit skeptical about my position, because Cengizip has now 9 civil actions, that's a big advantage. And he has 21 resources saved up, 8 productions, so he has the better economy for certain with having that many civil actions. And yeah, so I was a bit concerned, because while I maybe can, thanks to my culture production, make it that I have a little bit of a culture lead, with having all of those civil actions and resources, I thought Cengizip might be able to do some nice stuff. But he also has maybe a bit of some issues. At the moment he can't build more dramas, he has an unhappy worker only, soon he maybe has to put another worker into the farms, so he might be a bit limited with his population, but there's also computers, maybe movies available for him at the road the next turn, so I was a bit concerned, but I also thought it's definitely a position that can go in both ways, and no, but it could turn out to be quite a close game from how things are looking at the moment. And as you can see, I made a decision to see the impact of culture here. I certainly wanted to see it with the National Pride in there, and also with me being stronger. I could also maybe see it a little bit of a safer impact, like impact of industry or maybe impact of competition. But with Cengizip having those economical advantages, and with me being a little bit skeptical because of that, I thought it might be justified to take a bit of risk here. And also, I don't have the most military actions, meaning I can't keep that many cards in hand, and if I don't see the impact of culture now, it's not that easy for me to keep a lot of impacts in hand. I mean, of course, I think I will actually keep an impact in hand, so it's maybe not the biggest issue, but yeah, I just thought it is worth it to take the risk, because I can build more operas. Cengizip at the moment at least can't that easily go for a lot of culture production, even if he gets multimedias at some point. He doesn't have the most free population, he can go for some upgrades to movies, but those also don't increase his culture production by that much. So I was hoping that I have a chance to win this impact, but it's of course not for certain. And no. I will take the revolutionary idea here. And I first thought about an interesting turn where I maybe go for Cavalryman, then I can reveal the Modern Army tactic, that makes it that I'm actually weaker, I can then use the Wave of Nationalism and build an additional Cavalryman, and with that I would increase my strength by plus 10 going up to 27, so that would mean that Cengizib is a little bit under pressure maybe, and I get this going, and I can even do this and build an additional Opera. Thanks to the Cavalryman basically being for free, so I could increase my culture production and also go for the Cavalryman and go for a bit of a strength push. But the thing is, I don't really have a strong card in hand to really punish Cengizib in case he stays weaker. And also, I think at this point I was able to take a look at the cards from Cengizib, and he has 2 H, 2 defense cards in hand, the International Negotiations, and the Impact of Science. The Impact of Science, of course, is interesting to have knowledge about, and that he might be relatively easily able to win now that he went for the Harvard College. And 2 defense cards are not really enough to defend himself, so he could be a bit in trouble, maybe it would force him to go for an awkward turn. But I think it also would be a bit awkward for me, because I miss out on some draws. I can't really punish Cengizib, so I have to hope that he needs to do some awkward stuff, or that he will do some awkward stuff at his next turn. I mean, maybe he would go for tanks, and then he can't go for computers or movies or something like this, so there is certainly the chance that it will do some damage to him. But the thing is, if I go for Discovery Man and the Opera, I at the end would miss out on this copy of Revolutionary Idea, and that at the end I didn't want to miss out on, because I thought this Revolutionary Idea could make a big difference in maybe allowing me to go for an H3 government form, especially Democracy could of course be interesting, especially now that the Impact of Culture is in there, and so I didn't want to miss out on the Revolutionary Idea, also didn't want to leave it to Cengizib, and with that I can't go for the Strength Push and the Opera, and I also didn't want to miss out on the Opera, and so I just build the Opera this turn, and then I can also take the Reserves, the Efficient Upgrade, and increase my population. So also getting some more resources, the Efficient Upgrade I can use for my last upgrade from Printing Press to Journalist, and the Reserves is nice to have, so I just get a lot of nice yellow cards, increase my Culture Production, and maybe at the next turn I can also still go for Cavalryman and for a bit of Strength if I want to. At this point it could start to get interesting on when the Hollywood is revealed, because with us both being prepared with some theaters, it could be quite a strong wonder. The internet is in the row as well, so that wonder might still be available for me at the next turn, so it could be interesting when the Hollywood will be revealed and which player will be able to get it, and that was also one reason why I at this point made already sure that I maybe don't take too many cards from the row, maybe making it more likely that the Hollywood will be revealed at my turn. And then I draw 3 cards. The Impact of Strength could be interesting potentially, especially with me having the Modern Army tactic. And then a War and the Impact of Harmony. Harmony could maybe be a bit critical, because Cengizib has the Ocean Liner service, and if he puts some more workers into the military, he has quite a nice Harmony. But Impact of Strength is definitely interesting, so definitely an impact that I maybe can work around. Cengizib opens the National Pride, I have more culture, so I was happy to see that I was able to get more culture out of that. And Cengizib will now go for the movies, will increase his culture production like this. There's maybe also Iron Chaplin that is coming down the road, who will maybe help him with the happy faces, and now that he has movies also gives him a nice amount of culture production. He takes the endowment, has some additional culture from there, and also the computers to be prepared for the Impact of Science, because with having used Fleming at the turn before, I know that he has now seeded the Impact of Science, and that is of course nice to have this knowledge. And he also builds one more knight. Now it is my turn, there's no Hollywood revealed yet. I made this decision to seed the Impact of Strength. Again, it's a bit risky. It's not certain that I will stay stronger, but I will go for one Modern Army tactic this turn, going up to 27 strength, and and with that I was just hoping that I will have the chance to win this Impact of Strength. Cengizib might go for tanks and for some upgrades, but even if he upgrades all of those tanks, it would still not be enough to overtake me in strength. And it would also be quite expensive, so I was hoping. It's the same as for the Impact of Culture, it's not completely certain, maybe even a bit less certain, but I again was willing to take some risks here. I wanted to continue seeding with the National Pride. I have a little bit of a culture lead now, but there's also the Impact of Science in there, and I just thought maybe at the end I might need some strong impacts, especially if I should miss out on the Hollywood. And then the freedom of movement is revealed that I will use to put a lab into the opera, going up to 24 culture production. Now I will also use the efficient upgrade, making space in my hand and going for yet another upgrade. And now, then, as said, I want to go for the cavalryman, use the wave after having played the modern army tactic, build one going up to 27 strength. And now the interesting question is, do I want to go for the internet or not? Because the internet could also be, or is also quite a fine wonder for me. And if I don't take the internet now, there is still the fast food chain, so I might still be able to hope to go for this, but it's definitely a worse wonder for me than the internet. But the internet, on the other hand, is again a worse wonder for me than the Hollywood. And if I take the internet now, I make it that Cengizib knows that he will be able to go for the Hollywood. If the Hollywood is available in 3 civil actions, he doesn't necessarily have to take it. He can even let it fall down the row. And no. And I just thought, with Cengizib having the strong economy, all of those civil actions, if I leave him the Hollywood, even though I have maybe 2 potentially strong impacts in there now, it could get a bit critical, so I thought that I might have to take the gamble and that it is maybe better for me to leave myself open to potentially get the Hollywood, even if it could mean that I miss out on a strong wonder completely. Because just giving Cengizib the Hollywood for certain could maybe at the end not be enough. Maybe it could still be enough, maybe the internet could still give me a nice amount of points, but I was not so certain about it. And so I wanted to leave myself open for the Hollywood, and at least I have not the most civil actions, which is of course not great, but I really made sure also this turn to take very few cards from the row. This turn I will actually take no cards from the row that aren't under this card spot. And Cengizib, with having all of those civil actions and also with all of those nice yellow cards coming down the row, maybe he will also be careful to take not that many cards, but he somehow has to use the civil actions. So I was hoping that maybe I have the better chances on getting the Hollywood when I leave myself open for it. So I, after building the cavalryman, have now to spend my civil actions in a different way when I don't want to go for the internet. And I will do this with playing the revolutionary idea, with that I have enough science to go for a government form at the next turn. So I can maybe go for the government form while still having some civil actions left, maybe even potentially still having enough civil actions to grab the Hollywood, depending on where those cards are on the row. I take the satellites because I thought the impact of progress could potentially be a strong impact for Cengizib, and if I find the time and the science to develop the satellites, it could maybe be potentially scoring me some points. And with the last civil action, I then play the reserves for 3 resources. And I thought about also playing the H3 reserves because in case I still want to play one of those reserves for food, then, if I increase my population at the next turn, I will be at 2 food left, in 2 turns at 4 food, and then it could be better to play the reserves 2 for food, so that I have just enough food to get one more population going. Now I could of course still play those reserves for food, but then I can't play them for resource, I play those for resource now and I would basically miss out on resource. But I have only 6 civil actions. I might have to grab the Hollywood for expensive if it is available, so who knows if I will find the time to play the reserves 2 in time. I could of course also play it for food already now, but I didn't want to commit to the food already. I thought it might be maybe nice to be able to play reserves for food, but it might be more important to have the resources. And in case I really want to have an additional population, at least I can still take play those reserves for food, even though it will mean that I basically missed out on one resource and have one food lying around at the end that maybe isn't used. And like I said, don't take any cards from the row. I was really hoping that the Hollywood is not revealed. Also the democracy I was maybe hoping to get. So those were 2 cards that I was really keeping my eye on now to see whether those will be available. I draw another defense card. Cengizib seats, and there's the impact of strength revealed. I was really very relieved that it is revealed already now, because there might be a chance, also maybe if Cengizib goes for the military build-up, that he will overtake me in strength at some point. So I was really happy that its impact is now out, and that I was able to get 10 additional points from that one. Cengizib goes for the efficient upgrade, will use it with the Harvard College to go for his last upgrade to movies, but with only having those theaters, and not any libraries at the moment, even with having upgraded to 3 movies. I have still more culture production, so I was hoping that maybe my culture production could at the end be an important part, and all the culture lead that I now was able to build up, also with winning the National Pride, and also now having the impact of strength and potentially the impact of culture in there. Jengisip also has to kind of respond a little bit to my strength push, and he will do this with building 2 more knights, maybe also removing the option from him to build some more culture production or some economy, and then he will play take some yellow cards. Also the fundamentalist maybe doesn't want to leave this card available for me. That would give me an additional urban building limit and also boost my strength even more. And maybe Jengisip want to also keep some options potentially for himself to go for a military push. But it means that there are now 6 cards revealed, so I was really hoping that maybe there's the Hollywood as one of those cards, or if not, maybe the Democracy. And I was very happy to see that there is indeed the Hollywood revealed, and as you can see, I grab it immediately. With that, I was definitely getting more confident, and also with now having this big culture lead, thanks to the National Pride, Impact of Strength, and just generally being able to produce more culture. And now with also getting the Hollywood, I was hoping that I might now have quite a nice chances to win this game. Then after taking the Hollywood, the question is, what else do I want to do? And I came to the conclusion that I want to take the multimedia. First of all, I removed this option from Jengisip. That could be a way how I maybe can build up more culture production. There's another copy, but it might not be available for him. And even if it is available, he needs to pay more civil actions for it. And also the multimedia, in case the age ends at the next turn, I could now develop the multimedia, go for an upgrade, play the reserves, and then finish the Hollywood, and with that making my Hollywood even bigger. And also improving my culture production, especially with Fleming. Also this turn I think I again took a look at Jengisip's military cards. He has a lot of defense cards in hand from age 2 and age 3. The only impact that he has in hand is the impact of government. And then there is also an H3 raid in his hand, and also still the international negotiations, but he has only one impact, and that is the impact of government, which is of course a fine impact for him. So while he is behind in culture at the moment, he also still has the endowment in hand, he has the impact of science in the deck, another two more unknown impacts, and the impact of government, so I still have to be very careful. And then after taking the multimedia, the question is, what else do I want to do? And at the end, I just took this copy of reserves. That's maybe not really that much needed for myself, because if the age should end, then I can't use that anyway. One copy of reserve would be enough for the things that I want to do. But with taking it, I remove more cards from the row, making it more difficult for Jengisip in case he wants to prolong the game. If he prolongs the game, then the reserves could still be very nice to have, giving me even more resources and also removing one option for Jengisip to get more resources. And I just thought it might be nice if the game ends now and I can finish the Hollywood. I was thinking that might be nice for me. And so I wanted to increase the chances or make it more difficult for Jengisip to play a nice turn with prolonging the game. And also removing the reserves from him, which maybe could allow him to build up more stuff. Maybe with going for Empire State Building or building a lot of multimedias. And then I draw the Impact of Agriculture. I was very happy about this draw, and with that I got even more confident that I might have nice chances to win this game, because Jengisip has not more production than he has famine. Or then he has consumption, so that could be another strong impact for me. Jengis succeeds, and the impact of science is revealed now, that gives him plus 10 points. He will indeed go for the Empire State Building, develops the fundamentalism, with that he is stronger now, and we can also see that it was indeed quite nice for me that the impact of strength was revealed that early. Then he builds an additional mine, and he will actually finish the Empire State Building immediately, uses the Engineering Genius 2 for that, and scores 21 points with having completed the Empire State Building, but that of course won't be as big as my Hollywood. And then he takes the Engineering, and with that he also makes sure that the age will end, meaning he doesn't want to prolong the game. He has fewer culture production, and now that he has spent all of those resources, also can't build up a lot of culture production, can't really threaten a lot of strength in a potential war, so he just ends the age. But With me having this big Hollywood, I was hoping that I might have good chances now to win the game. And also, I will see the impact of agriculture. The impact of progress is revealed. I will go for democracy this turn, so that could have been improved, but it also was already in the second half of the deck. And it's a nice impact for Genghis Hibs, so he has at the moment more culture than me. The question is, now that the impact of progress revealed, should I still go for the democracy? Because there are basically two options, either I go for democracy and finish the Hollywood, or I go, as said in the turn before, for the multimedia, upgrade one and then finish the Hollywood. And the multimedia would give me plus 2 culture production, democracy gives me plus 3, but the multimedia would also give me plus 4 from the Hollywood, so basically giving me plus 3 culture that I score on my turn. But thanks to Fleming, I know that Genghis Hibs has the impact of government form in hand, an impact of government, and with that, the democracy with giving me 2 additional civil actions costs me also 4 points for the impact of government, and should with that be better. There could also be the impact of architecture, in that case both plays would be equal, but if not, then the democracy play will give me 1 additional point. And then I will go for the Hollywood for 38 points, also without going for the multimedia, that is still quite a nice Hollywood. And then it's Genghis Hibs' last turn, he will go for the Urban Growth, to spend the night, uses the Urban Growth to build an additional movie, thanks to having the fundamentalism that is possible for him. And then he also dispends some more knights, will actually build 2 farms in anticipation of the impact of agriculture, which and that's the right call because it is actually in there. And then he will play the endowment, develops the computers, and before the final impacts you can see that they have quite a decent culture lead. There is also the impact of culture in there, and with that I was very confident at this point. I think, I don't know if there are any impacts left for Genghis Hibs for me to overtake me. First of all, there is the impact of culture revealed, giving me plus 10. Then there's the impact of architecture that gives plus 3 to Genghis Hibs. There is the impact of agriculture that gives plus 1 for me. And the last impact is the impact of government, meaning that is another nice impact for Genghis Hibs, but I am at the end am able to keep my lead, and I'm able to win this game. And no. I'm definitely happy that I won this game, because the beginning of H3, I think it was quite an equal position, and I even thought that Genghis Hibs has maybe some advantages. Maybe I also underestimated my position, or maybe the problems that Genghis Hibs still had with maybe not having the most population available, not having that easy of a way to score a lot more culture production, so maybe I underestimated those issues. But with having 9 civil actions and just a bit of a better economy, and at the beginning of H3 being at basically the same amount of culture as me, I was quite concerned. But thanks to having journalisms and opera, I was able to build up quite a bit of a culture lead. And also with the National Pride and some nice impacts that I got thanks to the Politics of Strength. And then also Himeji Castle and St. Peter's Basilica, I think, did a nice job with just making it possible to keep up in culture production against Bach. Of course, also Fleming being revealed early in H3. Was quite strong for me. Having a culture leader definitely made it a lot easier for me to play against Bach. Maybe Genghis Hibs should have even taken Fleming away for 3 civil actions, but that is of course difficult to say. It would have been probably quite costly for him, but I think Fleming was just quite a strong leader for me, also giving me a bit of information about the event, about events, and allowing me to build up a bit of a culture lead. And then it, of course, was also a big part that I managed to get the Hollywood. I also made sure that not that many cards are revealed in Genghis Hibs because of having that many civil actions. Kinda had to take some cards, so I think I had maybe a good shot, but of course it still could have been revealed at Genghis Hibs' turn. I had a bit of a lead at the end, so maybe it could have still been enough for me even if Genghis Hibs gets the Hollywood, but it certainly would have been a lot closer then, and maybe then Genghis Hibs would be able to win the game. So that was also quite important, and no. So this game could have definitely gone into a different direction, but just thanks to having this nice culture production and then of course getting the Hollywood, I had a bit of an advantage, and also with having this tactic and the Imagic Castle, there was maybe not that many options for Genghis Hibs to catch up in or to try something with the military. Yeah, and with that, I at the end was able to win this game, which of course I'm very happy about, and we can also take a look at the standings now. And there actually also have been quite a bunch of games finished where I wasn't involved, so we will first take a look at those games and then take a look at the standings. And as you can see, I took a screenshot of those games. At the bottom you can see the last two games that you saw in the videos before, where I was able to win against Swin, and then the three-player game against Cengizip and Marta Pascher. And then the games are coming where I wasn't involved. Cengizip was able to win against Swin, winning a two-player game. Marta Pascher was able to win against Himmelstosh and Cengizip, so Marta Pascher getting a win in. Then Himmelstosh won a two-player game where Swin sadly timed out, so that's of course not great, but Swin wrote that he had quite a busy time with work, so sadly didn't manage to play his moves in time, and Himmelstosh won, but Payada said, I didn't take a look at the game, but Payada said that at the time when Swin timed out, Himmelstosh had already an advantage, so it is not really that big of a deal. And then we have a four-player game where Himmelstosh won against Swin, Cengizip and Marta Pascher. So quite a lot of games has finished, and also as you can see, Himmelstosh has scored quite nicely in them. And that leaves us now with the following standings. And of course, with having gotten another win, I have still a nice position in the standings. But as you can see, Himmelstosh is not that far away. We have both 10 games finished, and Himmelstosh is 7 points behind me. So I definitely still have a lead, but there are still 4 games left for both of us. And actually, in 3 out of those 4 games, we are both involved. So if Himmelstosh manages to finish before me in some of those games, it could definitely still get very close, and he has definitely still chances then to overtake me. So I have to be very careful to maybe finish in a nice position in those remaining games. And I think at that point it's also fair to say that the title might be decided between us two. Marta Pascher definitely doesn't have any chance any longer, Cengizip also doesn't have any, and Swin, I don't know if he wins all of his games, I think even then he might also not have enough points to still win the title. So it will now be a fight between me and Himmelstosh. In 3 out of the 4 remaining games we are both involved, so that could be quite an exciting finish. Of course, ideally I want to just finish before him in the next games and don't want to make it close at the end, but Himmelstosh, with having the chance to finish before me in those games, could definitely still make a comeback. And the next game that we are taking a look at will actually be a two-player game between me and Himmelstosh, and that could of course already first of all be a chance for me to maybe make a very big step towards the title, but also a chance for Himmelstosh to only be 3 points behind me after this game would be finished. So then he would already be quite close. So I hope you're looking forward to the next game to come. I hope that I will be able to get the next video going a little bit quicker, but I again will be a little bit busy now over the Christmas day, so I can't promise it, but hopefully I will find a time where I can record it. And then thanks for watching, have a nice time, and see you in the next video.